Well, in recent weeks, we've learned a lot more about those NSA scandals. It turns out the agency violated privacy rules over 3,000 times in 1 year. And now another abuse of power. Officials claim NSA officers used the agency's authority to spy on love interests. Spouses, boyfriends, girlfriends, several times. I'm joined now by South Carolina Congressman Trey Gowdy. Congressman, thanks for joining us this morning. This is almost unbelievable.
Yes, sir.
How does this make you feel about the repeated claims we're hearing from the administration that we ought to trust the NSA, the intel community, and the administration more generally?
Well, the cloak of trustworthiness was stripped away long ago, Tucker. Let's look at the chronology. We were first told the programs don't exist. That proved to be false. Then we were told it was only foreign, not domestic. That proved to be false. We were told there was sufficient oversight. That proved to be false. We were told it was all metadata and not content. That proved to be false. One of my colleagues, Tucker, specifically asked in a briefing, not classified, but in a briefing, could this be used so you could hypothetically spy on a lover? And he received a very condescending no. Well, it turned out my colleague was right, and the folks in the so-called intelligence community have been 0 for 6.
Well, then, I must say I've noticed most of the responses to those questions tend to be quite condescending. Why is it, though, that you're seeing, I hate to say this, but you see Republicans, you see conservatives, self-described, defending the NSA in this case? What happened to their natural skepticism about the growth and power of government?
Well, in some instances, it is difficult to balance public safety with privacy. And some folks, and I'm probably one of them, to be honest with you, as a former prosecutor who kind of overskews it towards public safety.
Yes.
But in the light of 6 different episodes of untrustworthiness, it doesn't require a cynic or a skeptic to not believe anything the intelligence community tells you anymore.
Well, it seems like there ought to be some kind of more direct and vigorous oversight. I mean, the Constitution provides for the Congress to oversee, to provide oversight to the executive branch, does it not? It does. So why is Congress allowing itself to be lied to? I mean, these guys have just flat out lied to you all. What are you going to do about it?
Well, we tried to do something about it with the Amash Amendment, and my suspicion if that amendment came up today, it would probably pass. It was only 7 votes short. And part of it, Tucker, is also the committee structure. If you're not on the Intelligence Committee, literally, you learn some of this information by reading the newspaper. So what I'm hopeful is that the folks who are fortunate enough to be on the select, hand-picked intelligence community or committee will do a better job of providing oversight and correspondingly do a better job of letting their colleagues know what's going on. Because in many instances, Tucker, I know no more about these programs than you do, and perhaps less.
That is really stunning that a member of Congress knows less than a journalist. Something is wrong with this system. Congressman, thanks a lot for joining us.
Yes, sir. Thank you.